Did you miss Ignite 2024? Microsoft dropped groundbreaking updates only a few days ago, and I'll share that with you. We have the cybersecurity zero-day quest with potential bounty of up to $4 million for cybersecurity experts. AI-powered tools, great speeches. Satya Nadella showed us how he uses Copilot in his daily work. He showed us how he uses Pages in Copilot. Copilot now is growing to an extent that will help us transform how we collaborate, how we automate tasks, how we do actions by using natural language prompts. We don't have to be coders anymore. Hi everyone, this is Ihab and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to summarize for you the whole week of Ignite updates that Microsoft just dropped on us. There were some groundbreaking updates. I know everyone's talking about Copilot, everyone is talking about AI, but there were a lot of interesting stuff. So for you, if you are an expert in the field, for your organization, if you are looking to budget for next year, what I'm going to share with you today is going to be very helpful for you. So buckle up and get ready for all of these updates in hopefully less than 20 minutes. So the very first announcement that Satya Nadella made was the zero-day initiative or the zero-day quest to help cybersecurity experts to work with Microsoft through a series of hackathons to find vulnerabilities, especially with AI solutions to ensure Microsoft users and customers work with secured data. So if you are an expert in this field and looking to potentially earn up to $4 million finding vulnerabilities, probably this is great news for you. There were updates around Copilot. For those of you who are not aware of what Copilot is the AI assistant that Microsoft to provide for organizations to enable their staff working with AI to collaborate, automate, and leverage the technology to do their day-to-day task. Again, M365 Copilot is tailored for work within organizations. So it's different than the other AI services that you've seen elsewhere because they are tailored for the individual user, while this is designed for the everyday organization work. Before I get into the details and talk about the Copilot pages, let's admire a little bit the amazing presentation skills from Satya Nadella. Let's have a look on how he presented Copilot pages and the use cases that he himself uses with this technology. Let's have a look.
With Copilot pages. Now, pages is this first artifact of the AI age, and it's pretty magical, right? You see in this video, we're bringing rich artifacts to pages. You can add interactive charts, tables, code blocks, math equations, complex diagrams. You can use Copilot directly on the page to iterate on the content and also control what happens on the page directly from a chat. It's truly this multiplayer canvas that enables you to ideate with AI and collaborate with other people. In fact, I use pages all the time. You know, in fact, if I'm prepping for a meeting, I just give it a prompt. The Copilot combs through everything about the customer, let's say, from the web, LinkedIn, all the business applications like our CRM. In fact, all the work artifacts, our documents, emails, Teams messages, presentations. And then I can put all of that just as a first draft into my pages and share it, let's say, with my account team, everyone working with me in my office. It becomes much more of a real-time way for every one of us who's working on that topic to be on the same page. And then it becomes, in fact, the first draft for what comes next, which is my meeting notes, right? Then again, it's real-time shared with everybody involved. Copilot is also not just in pages, but it's deeply integrated, right? It's not just about chats and pages, but it's deeply integrated into the entire.
So as you've seen there, the big man himself uses Copilot to do these tasks. And I myself have been using Copilot and 365 for well over 3-4 months now, maybe even 5 months. Time flies. It's almost 2025 now. I just remember editing Ignite 2023, and it feels like only a few weeks ago, and here we are in 2024. crazy. So I can't do my daily job without Copilot. I depend on it. All features, recaps, generating content, combining documents, creating rich media assets through the design. Now you pretty much have access to all the goodies in terms of AI models, but tailored for your organization needs. So again, we will cover more of the exciting stuff now. So for example, you have Actions, which is a new announcement that was made. So with Copilot Actions, you pretty much use natural language to tell AI, to tell your AI assistant to do things for you. Compiling reports, book meetings, get specific updates of the most recent activity and interactions between you and your manager. Things that you used, that probably used to take you half an hour, 20 minutes, accessing different apps, accessing different emails, looking through your history to compile this information. You pretty much, Copilot, do this for me. Copilot, send this invite. Copilot, do this booking for me. Don't make all this video about Copilot. So subscribe to the channel and I'll provide you with more demos and specific use cases so we can tailor the content if you're interested to learn more about Copilot. And back to what I said just earlier, the Copilot concept is growing in a way where AI is available for you pretty much in everything. So now you have custom specific agents that help you, that are tailored for specific tasks. For example, a facilitator agent that helps you with meeting management, calendar management, bookings, availability, working with Microsoft places. And you have the self-service agents, agents that help you with your human resources specific policies, your IT help desk support. So these would be tailored to service a specific need within your organization. And they are less broad than the Copilot experience that you typically get. And this concept of custom agents, where it's most powerful, in my opinion, it's when it comes to working with your own data within SharePoint, where you can, in few clicks, go to your data, it's all your compliance, all your security, everything you work with, it's still applied, and you select your data sources and create an agent on the go to be available for your user. So you can simply make an agent for all of your policies, your staff handbook. This is one of the best cases. You make that and users can go, oh, what's our social media policy? What's our leave policy? I'm looking to what's our incentives to do so and so. What initiatives that we are involved in? All sorts of the typical things that you get in an organization, you can pretty much put it in a bot and it does all these answers for you. We have Copilot Analytics, and this is great for anyone who is dealing with their internal business, with their executives, getting them to sign the dotted line and approve the licensing, which is showing the return on investment. It's really advanced. It's a comprehensive dashboard, shows you which departments are most active, how people are using it, how much time are they saving. So all this data, all these records will help you to determine that this is a worthy investment. So if you are looking to do a proof of concept, for example, with a smaller group, so if you have 1,000 users and you don't want to start with licensing all of these users, you can start with 50 people. And there's a reason I'm saying 50, because there are some goodies you will get with that. And you let them work with it for 2 months, for example. And then you can build your use cases based on the data and findings you get from the analytics, and you can tweak the experience. You could see where the weaknesses are, where you can improve. So you have that visibility and data-driven approach. And hopefully that will smooth the way for you with your executive and budget holders. There were also other updates around hardware and devices that will improve the collaboration, especially for remote workers and people who need to work and collaborate on the M365. Where there might be some security concerns, they don't have an image device, it's difficult to do that, it's costly. There is the Windows 365 link. Let's check it out and have a look together.
Johnson & Johnson, Siemens. And today, though, I'm really excited about the next big step here. And I'm really thrilled to announce Windows 365 Link. You can see it right here. It's a simple, secure, purpose-built device for Windows 365. It's admin-less, password-less, and security configurations are enabled by default and cannot be turned off. Windows 365 Link expands the PC category or the cloud PC category by connecting you directly to your productivity in the cloud with no data or information left on any device.
Another exciting update is Azure Local, which extends the Azure services across hybrid model, multi-cloud, on-the-edge locations, and centralize all these different Azure services in one central location. This centralized experience and this control panel will allow for great scalability for different use cases and different scenarios. So, for example, they mentioned Armada and how they use Microsoft services to keep that service active even when there is an extreme weather situation where there is no internet, but there is business continuity and service provided for these users in these locations. Okay, so I'm not an AI developer or a data scientist. I'm passionate and enthusiast about it, and I do dabble, develop things, work with models, but I don't call myself an AI developer. Because I'm not. But what I can tell you from my experience working with Azure AI, it's not a smooth experience, if we can say that. The services are spread all over the place. The voice service there, the recognition service is sitting there. It's not easy to manage. You can't find what you're looking for easily. And then when you want, for example, to work with voices and voiceovers, and then you have to go out of Azure, and then you go to a different URL and then link to your Azure account, it's not fun. So now the Azure AI Foundry is looking to centralize that experience where you have one user experience for AI management. You have areas for you to test, like a dev environment to work with AI solutions. You have over 1,800 models of quality, large language and other models from NVIDIA, Meta, OpenAI, etc. to help you build bespoke solutions. You have agent services to scale up your AI solutions. Data integration, where you can build a solution that integrates data from multiple data sources. So this is going to be a game changer, really, for people who work in this field. And I'm looking forward to work with it and experiment and see how that experience feels like. And finally, and like I promised you, I don't want to go over 20 minutes. One of the greatest updates for me, especially for what I do with the advanced content management space, the SharePoint Premium Services, the SharePoint Advanced Management in particular, is now going to be made available for you if you have M365 Copilot license within your business. Again, you probably need to have all your users licensed like before. There isn't much clarity on that, so we need to double check. But this is going to be a game changer. So SharePoint Advanced Management AI service to help you look through sharing vulnerabilities, do advanced reports, do actions. So for example, this site hasn't been touched for over 7 months. What do? You just do your policy, you can't get an update, you can't get an actionable email sent to the owner. Okay, Mr. Owner, you haven't been using this. Do you want to delete it? Do you want to archive it? What's the situation? So you could do lots of great stuff, and I'll make a specific video about that. What I'm going to say, 2025 is going to be another exciting year, another AI-focused year, another Copilot-focused year. So if you work in this field, it's going to be exciting for you. There'll be a lot of opportunities coming our way. There'll be a lot of exciting things you could do for your organizations and clients. I'll do a lot of content to help you in this space. And this is only the very first video about this update, but I'll do lots of demos, tutorials, and updates, cases. I'll do a podcast as well and host and fellow MVPs from Microsoft and other experts that will bring value to my very esteemed viewers. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Take care for now.